Good morning. I am Yogita Bhura. I am brand ambassador of School Khojo. Welcome to the interview session of principals. So today we are going to interview the founder of Brook School, Vanita Dogra. Vanita Dogra is a child psychologist and educationist with a teaching experience of more than 23 years. In 2005, she decided to take her passion of teaching a step further by establishing Brook Child Development Center at Kalyani, Nagar. As the name suggests, Brook is not just a preschool, but a child development center which looks after the holistic development of a child. In a short span, Brook has become a trusted and reputed name in preschool education. Madhuri Singh, the founder of School Khojo, and she's been reviewing schools since last 10 years, will be interviewing Vanita Dogra.
Good morning.
Good morning.
How are you?
I'm good.
How are you, Madhuri?
I'm good. So parents, welcome. And at the onset, I must tell you that Vanita is my favorite principal. After interviewing so many principals and teachers, she has become my lucky charm. So whenever there is something new which I start, I have to start with her.
Thank you so much, Madhuri. I appreciate it.
So ma'am, I'll start with this topic for today is how you are making your students future ready. Okay. So the first question is, what is the difference in teaching methodologies in 1990 versus 2016?
Madhuri, 1990, I remember as the year that my first born joined kindergarten. But I don't remember having any fun. I was a young mother and that was my first born and it was stressful. She was petrified of a teacher. She said, it's no fun, I don't get to play. There were homework to be done, there were tests to be conducted, and I had to prepare her, so I don't remember having any fun. Now, I see kindergartens as vibrant places where children love to come and they have fun. So I think that concept has changed. It's like a better environment.
Excellent. So what are the changes in learning methodologies in your school today versus 1990?
I think 1990 was all about the teacher. It was teacher-centric. Right. She was the boss in the class. She decided everything. And children were of no consequence. Now it's all about the child. Child, we know the child is unique, has different learning styles. He has multiple intelligences. So I think teachers now cater to each style of learning. Their lesson plans are more creative. And it's like a well-rounded session that they conduct in the class. And it's not boring. It caters to each child. So even a child who is a visual child gets to learn.
Right.
The children who like activities, they also have something to do. So it's a well-balanced learning now.
Yeah. It's really very difficult for me. I'm a person who understands by self-learning or by seeing things or drawing things. So anybody teaches me just doesn't get across.
Absolutely. That we all as teachers have to understand
right.
That.
Yeah. So what kind of policy changes need to be made to bring quality teachers?
See, if we want our children to be smart, we have to have smarter brains teaching them. As of now, I consider it a very safe profession. There are bored housewives who take up teaching. So you've not been able to clear any competitive exams, but you still want to work, you take up teaching. We need to have smarter brains. It has to be more competitive, more challenging, more pain so that smarter people also want to take up teaching and we end up having quality teachers.
I remember, you know, once I was interviewing a set of teachers as to why you have joined this profession and one of them said, ma'am, this is the job, you know, where when my husband moves from one city to another, I can get a job very easily.
I get teachers who say, I don't have any qualification, but I can teach because I'm a mother, which is not true.
Yeah, that's
which is not true.
So how do you prepare teachers to do the global and local needs changes?
See, globally or locally, a kindergarten teacher has to be a very warm person. She has to be soft-spoken. She has to understand the emotional needs of a child because she is replacing the mother figure. So I train them on the psychological and the emotional aspect of teaching and otherwise they all come as training teachers. So I train them that it's very important because if we fulfill the emotional needs, we have children who grow up having high self-esteem and that's very essential.
So what's your message to your parents
I always tell my parents, your child is unique. Stop comparing him with other children or even your other daughter. Each child is unique, even in a family. Stop expecting him to fulfill your dreams. Let him grow as the unique individual that he is meant to be. Let him, give him responsibilities. Let him think and nurture creativity. So, because he is a person to be unfolded, not a person to be molded. That's
right.
Thank you.
What are your contributions towards parents who will be joining?
Starting from 2016, we are going to conduct a series of workshops for our children. So every month there will be a workshop which will be related to child development, maybe how to bring up well-behaved children, how to discipline children, so that my parents, because they are first time, this is a kindergarten, and they have access to all this knowledge.
So I don't know whether you remember, but when I put my first son in your school, I had this idea, you know, one day I'm going to start a parenting course where I'm teaching how to raise children. And then I thought, if I'm too young, let me just gain a little more knowledge and experience, and then I'll restart.
I very well remember, Mama. You were a very good mother. Because you were having fun with your children,
yeah.
And you did not have a set of expectations from them. Even though you were not trained, but you were a fantastic mother. You have fantastic children today.
Yeah, thank you. So what is your school's education philosophy?
See, I consider kindergarten as the most significant time in the life of a child. This is where he learns about numbers, alphabets, about the world around us, and even about his own self.
Right.
So this has to be the happiest place for a child, for him to develop a love of learning and to be a confident learner. So that's what we do.
So thank you very much, Vanita ma'am, for this
thank
wonderful
you.
Interview.
Thank you.
And thank you parents for watching this.
Thank you.